Hello, everyone. So, good morning. Today, Garrett and I are going to be making a chocolate raspberry chia pudding. Now, there are lots of fads out there, lots of things to do, lots of things that people recommend or say that you should do, and then there's all the things that you shouldn't do, and so I don't get into that. I just know that it's fun to try new things. And if you have ever had a tapioca pudding, tapioca is kind of a spongy grain, and this chia seeds kind of do the same thing. So with this recipe, you may find that it's something that is interesting and something that you want to try in your efforts to do something healthier this year. A new 2017, a new year and new tastes as well. Okay, so this is chia seeds. These are chia seeds. Hold on, buddy. Let's show our audience what chia seeds look like. So chia seeds are just tiny, teeny, tiny seeds. And when you get them moist, they expand. And this recipe will give you a really, really tasty, tasty dessert. So if you like chocolate and you like raspberries, then this is the dessert for you. Okay, so we need 6 of these. You ready? Okay, so let me help you here. We're going to hold this together. You ready? Ready? 1. Okay, we need 5 more. 2. 3. And some on the table. That's going to happen. 4. Try and keep them all in the bowl, okay? Oh. Yeah, I know. We'll clean that up in a few minutes. Go ahead. 5. 1 more. Oh. It's okay. It's all right. 1 more. Here we go. Ready? 6. Okay. Oh. So now, yeah, they kind of went all over, didn't they? So now we have our chia seeds. Oh my. Son, did you pour that one even in the bowl? That one kind of went all over. Here we go. We're going to fix this. There's those. And these. Oh, my. Well, if you're going to have any kind of exercise with a 2-year-old, it will include some cleanup. Okay, hold on. Here we go. Let's put you down here for just a second. Let's clean off the chair so that you're not slipping and sliding, because these act like very slippery when you have them on the floor. Okay, we'll get to that in a minute. The next part, so 6 tablespoons of chia seeds. We use Nature's Intent. They're organic chia seeds. I don't know if there's a difference between organic and not. We just do organic as often as we can. Okay, now the next part of the recipe calls for 2 cups of milk. Now we use plant-based milk. You can use coconut. It actually calls for coconut milk. I don't have any coconut milk on hand, and I don't usually buy coconut milk, but I do have soy milk. So we're going to put 2 cups of soy milk. Hold on, we got to keep pouring. Keep pouring. Help me pour it. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Right there. Okay. And ho-oh is right. Now the recipe calls, no, please don't pour that out. That would not be good. The recipe says to put your chia seeds in with the milk and make sure that they are all covered. So using, by the way, we use a lot of Pampered Chef stuff. I love their tools. So just using this right here, mini whisk, we're just gonna make sure that all the chia seeds are covered. Okay, you want to stir that for a minute? Okay, you stir that for just a minute. I'll clean up this little mess right here. Now remember, we're not pouring that yet, right? Just stirring it. Keep stirring, just keep stirring, just keep stirring. Now, the next thing that it calls for in our recipe, thank you for stirring that. You just keep going. It says to use some dark chocolate squares. Now, I don't have any dark chocolate squares right on hand, so I'm using what I do have. And what I do have is I have some mini chocolate chips for another recipe that Garrett and I will make. And they're called Energy Bites. You can Google it, by the way. They are so yummy. And for the most part, really, really good for you. I suppose if you wanted to split hairs, the chocolate in it may not be the best for you. But for this pudding, we're going to make sure this is stirred in here. You're doing a good job at stirring that. Thank you for stirring. It says that we're supposed to use a knife and shave the chocolate. So you be careful stirring that. I'm going to come over here, and I am going to get, we're going to put this off to the side, and you can see on our cutting board, we have our chocolate chips. So what Garrett and I are going to do is we're going to cut these chocolate chips. I'm just going to cut them down a little bit finer, and then we'll melt them on the stove. We'll come back later and actually put the finished product together and share that with everyone. But this is how I cut. I put my hand at the end of the knife and press down onto the cutting board, and then with my other hand, I just raise the knife, kind of in a clock manner. And my taste tester makes sure that we have good, are they good tasting? Oh, good. I'm glad. I'm always very careful, of course. I've had people private message me and say that they were concerned about the hot skillet or something. And I want you to know that I'm always here when it is hot. When I first place things in front of my son, they're either turned off or cool to the touch. Or if they're dangerous, then I pick them up. Now, some will question why I started with so many chocolate chips this morning. That's because I know my son. Okay, so you have to move your fingers because I can't cut when your fingers are right there. There you go. Smart boy. Now, some of this will actually get mixed in with the chia and the milk. Here's two down here. You can have those. And some of this will actually be melted and then mixed with the raspberries. So, now, I encourage parents to do as much as they can with their children. I taught school for 14 years. And in that time, many of my conversations with the parents said things like, include your children in the grocery shopping, or include your children in the yard work, or include your children in the housework. Not just have them do it, but actually do it with them. And one of the reasons for that is so that they take ownership and they feel like they own part of it. Are those good? Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's see your hands. Well, they must be good. Lots of cleanup with little kids. Hi, Debbie. So if you want to check out this raspberry chocolate coconut dessert, you can actually get your own copy of the Healthy Living Revolution cookbook. I have included that link up above. We released that this at the very, very end of 2016, and the reason was because we know people are wanting to make healthier choices. They want to live healthier. And by providing a cookbook that has hundreds of clean eating recipes in there, easy recipes, nothing that takes forever to prep and then do. Some of the recipes can be created with what you have on hand, like an apple and a sweet potato and an onion. Really, really easy recipes that are delicious, filling, and the kind of recipe that when you walk away from it, you realize, hey, I just ate something healthy, but it didn't feel like it was healthy because it tasted so good. Healthy can taste really, really good. Garrett and I, our wish for you is that you will do something new this year. Be bold. Take a chance. Take an opportunity to do something new, to taste something new, to eat something that you wouldn't maybe have eaten last year, because this year you're looking at doing healthier things. So as you enjoy your experiences, or as you encounter new things, feel free to tag me in those. I love to learn new things. I love to see what other people are doing and include that in our family's journey through health. You know, we've been very blessed. You know, I've said before, we have 11 years, going on 12. My kids haven't been on antibiotics for sickness. Our whole family has enjoyed being strep throat free. And years ago, it was not uncommon to have strep throat every other month or at least two or three times a year. And now, of course, we haven't had any of that. I don't anticipate having any. You going to save any of those for our dessert? No, he says no. But I don't anticipate hauling my children to the doctor because they've been sick. They're around sick kids. We don't homeschool. They are at school. And we have both public and, charter schools that our children attend. And so it's not like they're in the private education somewhere and we're paying $5 million a year in tuition. My kids are around the kind of kids your kids are around. The real benefit is when you feed your children healthy, when you feed your families healthy, people are sick less often. And by being sick less often, everyone misses work less. Everyone misses school less. Everyone enjoys life more. And that is our hope for you today. We hope that you find joy in experimenting with healthier things, new things, whether it's exercise or whether it's healthy, positive thinking or whether it's spiritual health or whether it truly is physical health with your diet and nutrition. So our hope for you is that you will make this year a new experience for you and your family as we are continuing to do for ours. Everyone have a wonderful day, and we'll come back later with the finished product. Garrett, say bye-bye.
No.
Yeah, because if I don't have an ending now, there will be no chocolate left for our dessert, and that truly would be a travesty. Have a wonderful day, everyone. Bye-bye.